Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be going over the new Bluetooth battery monitor by Renogy. If you guys are purchasing anything from Renogy, be sure to use the discount code MADETOTRAVEL when you go to check out and you'll get a discount. If you guys are having trouble installing a solar system in your camper van, your RV, your trailer, your boat, your off-grid solar system, I have developed a simple solar guide. It includes a component breakdown, a wiring schematic, a parts list, so it really covers everything you need to know if you are just getting into solar. Renogy actually came out with this last year, but I finally got my hands on it and I'm so excited to install it. I have the Renogy 400 amp hour battery installed right now and it does have Bluetooth. One of the problems I've been having with it though is when I'm in the front of the van, I can't get a Bluetooth signal very well and it's really in and out. I'm hoping that this will provide a better connection. Kaylee and I have really been relying on the original battery monitor with the shunt by Renogy, but of course, as you guys know, that is not Bluetooth. And this is gonna be perfect for anyone who doesn't have Bluetooth built into their battery, which is a lot of people out there. And good news, this thing actually works with any type of battery you might have. What you get in the box is the user manual, then you get two wires. One of these will hook up to your starter battery. I plan on connecting this straight to my DC to DC charger, which is tied in to the starter battery on the van. And then the other one is going to connect to your house battery bank. Then you also have a handy little temperature sensor, which you can probably mount beside your battery, so you know roughly what your battery's temperature is going to be at. And finally, you have a few mounting screws for the shunt itself. This is actually a lot bigger than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a little more compact and easier to fit in the system. We'll see how it fits into my system. A little bit worried about space. If you already have the Renogy One Core, which I actually have it installed, I tend to use my phone mostly, but if you do have the Renogy One Core, this is compatible with it and it will hook up to it. And if your core is hooked up to Wi-Fi in your camper van, you'll be able to see what your batteries are at from anywhere. This smart shunt can handle a maximum of 300 amps with a 10 second surge of up to 500 amps. Most people will have a maximum of a 300 amp inverter, which uses about 250 amps if you're maxing out that inverter. So this should be enough for a majority of people out there. This also comes with a 1 year warranty. This is the battery monitor that Kaylee and I have been using since I built out the van. So we've been using this thing for probably like 2 years. It's worked phenomenally. I've never had any issues with it. I've also tested out a ton of different solar components with it, and I have found that it is pretty reliable, but it will be nice to upgrade to a Bluetooth one so I can just pull out my phone, because that is what I usually use to monitor our solar system. I really hope that the app is gonna show all the same stuff that this monitor does. Along with this guy, I also have the BT2 connected to my DC to DC charger with MPPT, and honestly, I haven't used it very much. It's a really cheap product that does work. It does what it's supposed to. It's just not all that reliable because it doesn't have a shunt. Installing this is going to be really straightforward. You simply unscrew these two screws on top, pop that cap off, and then on the side here, this cover just pops off. I already had it like a little loose there. On the side here, you're going to have the plug-in for the temp sensor. There is a second temp sensor right here. It's blocked off by this, so probably just one temperature sensor. On these green ports here is going to be where you're going to connect your positive from your starter battery and your house batteries. And then I believe these are M10, and these are where you're going to connect your negative battery. I got a ton of questions on my last battery monitor review. People were installing them backwards, so they weren't getting the right readings. And it's really important to install these in the right direction because it's only gonna be able to read current one way going through. So you wanna make sure, follow the instructions, and keep in mind there is a B negative sign and a P negative sign. One thing to mention is I do not think my 4-aught wire is going to fit here and here. So we'll see how that goes. I think 2-aught wire would probably fit, but 4-aught, I don't know, might be leaving this cover off for my installation. We'll see. Step number one before working on any solar components is turn off the solar panels and turn off the battery. These nuts on the shunt are 17 millimeter. I think you can also use an 11/16, but the 17 millimeter seems to work the best. All right, guys, so I don't have this mounted anywhere. I would obviously recommend mounting this due to the fact that it's a little chilly out and these wires are not all that flexible. I've just kind of got it roughly wired up here, but let's go through the install process. When I mentioned earlier, I wasn't sure if this battery cover was going to fit. I was absolutely correct. So the holes on either side are just not big enough for my battery wires. Like, it just will not go on. There's not a chance. So that's a little unfortunate, but it is what it is. Not the end of the world, of course. The most important thing when installing this shunt is the fact that you do connect it in the right orientation. So the B minus goes to your battery and the P goes to your shunt. Make sure that that is correct when you're wiring it in or it's not going to read correctly. Next up, the B1 port goes to your positive shunt or to your positive terminal on your battery. I've connected it to my positive shunt right there. The B ports are the green ports, by the way. The B2 port goes to your starter battery. I didn't run mine all the way to my starter battery. What I did is I ran it up to my DC to DC charger and that wire runs all the way to my starter battery. So that was a lot easier for me. And then lastly, I just have the temperature sensor kicking around there. It's just hanging out here. This isn't really a big deal for me. If you don't have a heated battery, then this is going to be quite important because you can probably set up alarms so that the app will notify you when your battery gets cold. But because I have the heated battery right here, I don't have to worry about that because the battery does it itself. All right, get a orange light there. Can go ahead and turn my solar panels back on. And it is just doing a nice little beep there.
When I first connected the device, I was getting a constant beep. The power light was orange and the green light was flashing to indicate that it is connected. There's also a little manual reset button on the front, which is handy if you need to reset the device. But I went into the app and I just changed some of the settings so I wasn't getting that constant beep. Let's go into the app and I'll show you guys how to connect to it and some of the settings. Open up the DC home, go into the plus icon in the top right, add device, and then this is where you're gonna see the battery shunt. So you can click on that, hit confirm, and then it'll bring you back to this home screen where the battery shunt will be located along with my other Renogy components. We can go into the battery shunt and it says it's at 100% charging. So when we scroll down here, it's pretty much the same settings as the Renogy battery monitor that I previously had installed. It's time to full charge. So if my batteries weren't all the way charged right now and we were getting more power into them, it would tell us how long it takes to get to the batteries to full, which is really nice. And then underneath there you have battery volts, charge amps, power, charge duration, charged amp hours, starter battery voltage, and the temperature, which is at 13 degrees right now. In the top right, if you click the three icons, you can go into settings. We can set the amp hours. So I have 400 amp hours. We'll go confirm, state of charge sync, sync to 100% because my battery's at 100%. Then we can go into the alarm and there is low SOC alarm, go on. And then this is where you can just customize a lot of these settings. I've set the trigger value to 20% because to get the most out of your lithium iron phosphate batteries, between 20% and 80% is the best range. But once you get below 20%, that's not great for the battery. So you want to try to stay above that. You can also just turn this off because sometimes the buzzer does get kind of irritating, honestly. So I might do that here. Next up is high charge amps alarm. So if you're worried about how much amperage your battery is getting, you can turn this on. Depending on what type of battery you guys have, you want to pull up the settings for it and then adjust these settings in the app to line up with those. High charge amps, depending on your battery, how many amps can you charge at? If it's a 100 amp hour battery, maybe you can only charge it up to 100 amps. So you'd want to set that alarm at that. So if it goes above it, you'll get an alarm. You'll be like, oh my gosh, my batteries are being charged way too fast. Then we have high discharge amps alarm, same thing. High voltage alarm, low volts alarm, battery high temp, and battery low temp. So for me, I'm probably going to turn the low temp off because I have the heated batteries, don't need it. Battery will automatically start heating when it's too cold. High temp, probably going to leave that on because I want to be notified if my batteries get too hot for sure. And then we have general. So you can reset your historical data here, and then it also shows you the serial number. And that is everything for the settings. So this is awesome. You can also go into historical data and see when you were last charged, total consumed power, total charge cycles, last charge amp hours, total charge kilowatt hours, max battery volt, min battery volt, max temperature, min temperature. So this is awesome, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to comment below. If you found this video useful, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends who might be installing a solar system as well. And I'll see you guys in the next one.